Hey guys, welcome to the hacked existence demo of the DSTIKE Deauth Detector. So a while back, I did a video on the DSTIKE Deauth Wristwatch, which basically allows you to mount Deauth attacks from the watch against 2.4 gigahertz clients, because this is an ESP8266 under the hood. Basically lets you kick those people off the Wi-Fi. So this is another product from Spacehuhn. This is also ESP8266 based. So again, only 2.4 gigahertz, but it is a Deauth detector, and it'll detect more than just the wristwatch attacks. But if you believe somebody is using one of these watches on you, you should probably check this out. So basically, you plug it in and give it power. You can plug it into a computer if you want, but you don't have to. A battery is fine. It'll turn on a green light. That means everything is okay and there are no attacks going on. So if we start a Deauth attack, you'll see in a second here, it turns red and plays a tone, and it'll continue playing that tone for as long as that attack is underway. Once we stop the attack, you'll see after a second, it'll turn back to green. So this can basically tell you if anyone in range is mounting 2.4 gigahertz based Deauth or deassociation attacks. So let's jump in and take a look at the code of how this works.
All right, so on the DSTIKE website, we can see that the Deauth detector comes pre-flashed for $14, and we can see a picture of what it looks like on the inside. Basically, looking at Spacehuhn's GitHub repo over here, the first thing that we'll notice is in our setup function, we have Wi-Fi promiscuous enable. So this basically turns that ESP8266 into a packet listener. It's just going to listen to all the Wi-Fi packets flying by. The next thing that happens is that we drop packets without a MAC header. And so this is actually a really neat way to gain a bunch of efficiency, because a deauthentication attack requires you to have a target that you're attempting to deauthenticate. Without a MAC address in the header of the packet, you can't perform a deauthentication attack. So we're going to ignore all of the packets that are clearly not deauthenticated attacks. If it does have a MAC address in the header, then the next step is to see if the deauthentication or disassociation flags are set. If they are, then we increment this packet rate. So up here we can see PKT rate, which will ultimately get compared against the packet rate variable to trigger the alert. So up here we can tune the number of deauth packets that we need to see prior to triggering alert.
All right, so hopefully by this point I've demonstrated to you guys that the DSTIKE Deauth detector is capable of detecting any deauthentication or disassociation attack, not just those from the watch, but also includes the ones from the watch, so long as it's on 2.4 gigahertz. So whether you believe somebody is using one of these watches to attack your network, or you just have constantly intermittent Wi-Fi on 2.4 gigahertz, or you just like to add another green light to your wall of blinking lights, at $14, the DSTIKE Deauth detector is just a great tool to add to the toolbox. So as always, stay tuned and thanks for watching.